In recognition of this fact, this government has initiated a dramatic shift in how we approach health care in this province. Essentially, as the Minister's Advisory Committee on Health recommended, health care in Alberta must become more patient-focused. And to meet this goal, there needs to be a legislative framework in place. In recognition of this need, the government will introduce the Alberta Health Act later this fall, after it has been guided by Albertans themselves. Mr. Speaker, beyond legislative controls, a successful health care system needs two things. One, to have access to predictable funding, and two, to be accountable to Albertans. Therefore, I'm pleased that His Honour stated that there would be a stable five-year funding plan introduced in Budget 2010, as well as the idea that health care will be accountable because of a commitment to performance consultation with everyday Albertans. I'm also pleased how the speech from the throne highlighted this government's commitment to safe, strong, and caring communities. Commitments like adding 100 new police officers and creating 14,000 new childcare spaces are among these highlights. Mr. Speaker, this government recognizes that it takes more than enforcement to ensure our communities remain safe. Rather, it takes an understanding that a truly safe community only comes with a commitment to social programs and to those in need. Communities like those highlighted by the Lieutenant Governor. As he stated, this government will continue to work towards its pledge of providing 11,000 affordable housing units by 2012. And this government will ensure that social programs become better integrated so that they focus on the people they were intended to serve. After all, a program is only useful if it successfully targets the people in need. The improvements proposed by this government will ensure that Albertans have access to the information they need to effectively transition from programs to program at each stage in their lives. Mr. Speaker, while I applaud this government's commitment to both health care and safe communities, I'm also intrigued and excited about how this government proposes to keep Alberta in the forefront of global competitiveness. After all, Alberta's competitive edge has enabled us to be the best place in Canada to live, invest, and ultimately succeed, and it is essential that we retain this edge. For this reason, I was pleased to hear His Honour's statement that Bill 1 of this legislative session would be Alberta Competitiveness Act, which will ensure that Alberta remains the most competitive jurisdiction in North America by minimizing the cost of doing business in the province. However, Mr. Speaker, competitiveness means more than just having a strong business climate, which we do. It also means a commitment to education and innovation. This is why this government will continue to develop the Alberta Innovates program to better reflect the needs of entrepreneurs and researchers in order to help ensure that Alberta's technology plays an ever-increasing role in the world economy. And beyond the economy, education and technological innovations will also help us address the needs of our environment. As His Honour stated, our history of technological breakthroughs and engineering has gone a long way towards shrinking our environmental footprint. And that is the words drive towards cleaner energy is a welcome fact, welcomed by both the Alberta government and Alberta's strong business community. Mr. Speaker, the commitment by both the government and our business community is exciting. And this commitment will enable us to develop a well-thought-out and equitable approach to controlling greenhouse gas emissions while ensuring that our energy industry remains strong. Finally, I would like to conclude on the same idea Addis's honour Alberta's place within Canada. I'm truly proud to be a Canadian, just I am proud to be an Albertan and serve the people of this great province. And as the Lieutenant Governor stated, Albertans are proud to contribute to the well-being of our nation. We only ask to be treated fairly by federal programs. After all, Mr. Speaker, a sick or unemployed person is still sick or unemployed regardless of where they live. For this reason, I'm pleased that our government is committed to working with the federal government to promote regional equality. After all, I believe that a strong Canada needs a strong Alberta. Mr. Speaker, it has been an honour to rise today and move acceptance of the speech from the throne, just as it has been an honour to serve as the elected representative of the people of Edmonton-Ellerslie. And in closing, I would again like to thank His Honour, the Lieutenant Governor, for his inspiring words and dedicated public service. And I again, our Honourable Premier and his strong leadership and noble vision. I believe that under the guidance of these two men and with the dedication and spirit of people of Alberta, we can make a future which we can all be truly proud of. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker.